So for number 5, we're supposed to describe F, F prime, F double prime. NEI, by the way, is not enough information. Not enough info. Okay. So just starting with number with A, this point A on, this is the graph again of y equals F of x. Okay. So at point A, we see that F is greater than 0 because the function's value is above the x-axis. So F is greater than 0. F prime is equal to 0. Horizontal tangent line, what is F double prime? Less than 0, because it's concave down right there.
Negative.
So it's concave down, so F double prime is less than 0. B, we again, F is greater than 0. F prime is less than 0. Still concave down, so F double prime is less than 0. Right here, it's still concave down, but F is equal to 0, F prime less than 0, and F double prime less than 0. The slope here is negative, so that's why we have F prime less than 0. The F of X is concave down there, so F double prime is less than 0. That's why. Okay. So at point D, we can see that F is less than 0. Now all these points here are underneath the x-axis, and so the value F has to be less than 0. F prime, though, still negative, so less than 0. Slope is still negative there. The second derivative, though, it looks like that's our inflection point. So we're going to say that F double prime is equal to 0 right there. Okay? And then for the rest of these, I want you guys to participate a little bit. E, what is F? Less than 0. F prime?
Less than 0.
F double prime?
Greater than 0.
Now we're concave up. Okay? F is at F? Less than 0. F prime?
Zero.
Equals 0. F double prime? Greater than 0. Concave up. F is for G? Less than 0. F prime?
Positive.
Slope's positive there. F double prime?
Greater than 0.
All right, good job. Hold on, I didn't. There. There you go.